It's now my pleasure to bring to the podium Brenda Hicks, our NASFAA past national chair, who will provide another award.
All right, heads up, everyone new in the room. And Joan, you are my hero. Thank you. This is amazing. Amazing speech, amazing person. And speaking of amazing people, this next award winner is probably, when I went to my first NASFAA conference like you all out there, this person stood up and spoke, and his lyrical voice and passionate speech probably is the reason I am still here today. Neville Brown, Associate Director of Financial Aid at Eastern Connecticut State University, is the winner of the Meritorious Achievement Award. Neville Brown's career in financial aid has spanned more than 25 years, all at Eastern Connecticut State University. He has served in many capacities with CAPFA and ESFA, including as state and regional president. Neville has also served on NASFAA's board as ESFA's representative and as a representative at large. Brown has been a longtime advocate for advancing the financial aid profession. He introduced Financial Aid Day at that conference I'm speaking of. Financial Aid Day has now been adopted by all and celebrated annually in October. He also introduced the Mentee program in Connecticut. Brown's immense personal integrity, devotion to students and their success, and belief in the mission of financial aid to serve students makes him very deserving of this award. Neville, why don't you come up and receive your award?
When I was told, good morning, good morning, good morning. Good morning. That's good. You know, when I go on the elevator and I say good morning and nobody answers, I walk off and come back on and say good morning. I'll make this quick because I was told if I talk too long, they'll pull me off the stage. I want to thank you all for supporting NASFAA's conference. The first time attendees, I say to you, in the words of Bob Marley, don't worry about a thing. Every little thing is going to be all right. So far, it has been a great conference, and I am having a time of my life, especially since I will be retiring on July 1. I'm told I have a few minutes to acknowledge my award, so in the spirit of mentoring, I encourage you to light a candle instead of cursing the dark. And I ask you to remember that no candle has ever lost its flame by lighting another candle. So go ahead, mentor someone and be mentored. Not only mentor someone who is already in the business, but also mentor someone into the business and help to grow our business. In short, I'm asking you to mentor and help a colleague to enjoy a successful career as you have. So I'm asking you to send the elevator back down. When you get up there to the top floor, you've got to send it back down so other people can take it on the way up. I challenge you to live your life in dreams of how you'd like to be remembered. If you'd like to be remembered as a selfish jerk, live your life in that regard. But if you'd like to be remembered as a caring, unselfish person, live your life accordingly. I supplicate you to remember that God gave us two hands, one to receive and one to give. Thanks to all my CAPFA, ESFA, and all other regions, my regional colleagues and NASFAA, for your support over the years. You have helped me to make my financial aid career most enjoyable and effective. Thanks to my institution, Eastern Connecticut State University, and my office colleagues for your support. Thanks to all my family and friends for your untiring support. You are the best of the best. And as my Panamanian college girlfriend used to say, you're the bestest. I am very honored and grateful to receive this meritorious award. I know by receiving this award, it signifies that I did something good over my career and will be leaving something good behind. In the words of Jamaican Grammy-winning reggae star Gramps Morgan, from his beautiful reggae ballad, People Like You, he said, "It's not what you take with you when you go, it's what you leave behind." I hope I'm leaving something good behind. Thank you, thank you, thank you.